whole grains exactly? What are they good for? Aren't all grains pretty much the same? I buy enriched grains. Aren't those better? Today, we're going to answer all of these questions regarding the whole truth about whole grains. Hello everyone, I'm Begonia. I'm a professor, dietitian, and nutritionist. I love to help you and your family become healthier 1 week at a time. Don't forget to like this video and get weekly health news by subscribing to my channel, Simply Health. We have all eaten grains, and you're probably eating them daily. Some examples include wheat, rice, oats, barley, corn, rye, millet, amaranth, and quinoa. We find these grains in breads, tortillas, pastas, rice, cookies, bakery goods, tortilla chips, popcorn, pizza doughs, crackers, and cereal. All products made with grains, or Caryopsis, for my Trivial Pursuit fans, have the same anatomy. The bran, which is a group of outer layers, the endosperm, which is the largest portion of a grain, and the germ, which is the part that could grow roots if the conditions were just right. The bran contains the most fiber, B vitamins, iron, copper, selenium, zinc, magnesium, calcium, phosphorus, antioxidants, and phytochemicals. You can purchase it by itself, for example, to make bran muffins. The endosperm is where we find the calories in grains. These come from protein and complex carbohydrates. Be careful not to confuse the carbohydrates found here to sugars or fructose, as they are very different and they act differently in the body. Lastly, the germ contains vitamin E, phytochemicals, antioxidants, fiber, B vitamins, and the minerals zinc, magnesium, iron, chromium, selenium, and phosphorus. When we eat whole grains, we are eating all three parts of the grain, hence the word whole in whole grains. When they are refined, the milling process only keeps the endosperm. Examples of refined grain products include white bread, sourdough bread, white bagels, white pasta, white rice, white tortillas, and most bakery goods. So eating refined grains means that we say goodbye to that long list of nutrients naturally found in the bran and the germ of a grain. Although iron and 4B vitamins are added back by law to refined grains, the following are not added back: fiber, phytochemicals, vitamin E, antioxidants, calcium, selenium, phosphorus, potassium, zinc, magnesium, copper, chromium, and 4 of the 8B vitamins that are found in whole grains naturally. It doesn't take a mastermind to realize that taking away so many essential nutrients from foods that we eat daily may have negative long-term health effects. To understand these, let's take a look at the health benefits of consuming whole grains instead of refined. These health benefits have been proven by scientific evidence for years. Heart health. The antioxidants and fiber in whole grains help reduce the risk of heart disease and strokes. Blood cholesterol. The fiber in whole grains actively reduces levels of bad cholesterol in your blood from the moment that you eat them. Diabetes. Whole grains slow down the absorption of carbohydrates during digestion, which decreases the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Weight loss. Whole grains increase calorie loss by decreasing the number of calories held in the body during digestion. Additionally, whole grains speed up your metabolism. They also tend to be more filling, so you end up eating less and losing weight. In fact, eating 3 servings of whole grains daily was linked to lower body mass index and less belly fat in a review of 15 studies in about 102,000 people. Cancer. Much scientific evidence exists that fine whole grains are protective against colon, gastric, breast, and prostate cancers. Gastrointestinal health. Whole grains decrease intestinal transit time, which in turn decrease constipation, which is crucial to lowering your risk of developing colon and colorectal cancers. Immune system. The fiber in whole grains benefits the immune system by increasing the food that our gut bacteria or microbiome require to keep our immune system strong. These fibers are also known as prebiotics, because they feed our healthy gut bacteria. In this perfect symbiotic relationship, the more we feed them, the larger the numbers of our microbiome and the stronger our immune system. Mental wellness. Studies are relatively new, but worth noting. Switching to whole grains is inversely related to anxiety and depression. So the more whole grains in your diet, the less likely to suffer from these disorders. After learning all the benefits of whole grains compared to refined grains, it makes sense to want to switch. Here are some tips to help you with that process. Although some people may do this cold turkey, I personally had a hard time trying to switch to whole grains overnight. But you should certainly try that route, as you never know what may work. First, be sure that you're actually purchasing whole grains. The color of the product doesn't tell you much. Check out this bread. It may look like whole wheat bread, but if you check the ingredients list, you see no whole wheat at all. It is the caramel color and dark white flour that makes this bread look darker than it should be. The only way to be sure is to look at the ingredients list. 100% whole grain will have only whole grain flours as the first ingredients. The term wheat flour does not mean whole grain. Brown rice is also a whole grain. So is wild rice, oats, and corn kernels, like in popcorn. Don't be tricked by other terms like enriched or unbleached. These do not mean whole grain. Check for the whole grain stamp. The Whole Grain Council has a stamp that signifies that a product is whole grain. Also, increase your water intake when you increase your intake of whole grains. Why? Because the increase of fiber can constipate you. I know, it sounds counterintuitive, since fiber normally helps you decrease constipation. Sticking with the same amount of water will cause for your colon to dry up as the extra fiber absorbs more water. This will in turn cause constipation. Increasing water intake will stop this symptom. You can start with half and half, half whole grains, half refined. For example, mix half brown rice with half white rice. Do this for a few weeks to get your palate used to the switch. Slowly add more brown rice and less white until you've completely eliminated the white rice. The same goes for any other whole grain product. But if you're like most people, you will find that some products are easier to switch than others. I hope your switch goes smoothly. Don't forget to leave comments below and like this video if you learned something new. Thank you for joining me. Until next time, cheers to your health.